From the dawn of cinema up until this day, the core idea behind creating a film has always been telling a story. Sometimes this storytelling may involve some scenes that are impossible in different ways. The range may go from some minor stuff like shooting a scene in an exotic place all the way to shooting in a space. That's when green screen comes to play. Let's shoot the scene from the comfy greenness of our studio and let the hassle be taken care of by the editing software. Cool, let's do that. But how? How do green screens work? How should I set up? Or before anything else, why even green? What's so special about green? Well, let's answer that. Cool. You know the jungle has its rules. And I just gotta keep it cool. And I'll be treated like a tool. So don't be acting like a fool. Well, first, to take care of the basics, green screens were not always called that, because they used to be blue. Even today they are for some needed situations. But the main reason blue and green are the main key in colors is that human skin consists of so many shades of red, and that can cause so many problems during the keying process. But when should we use blue and when should we use green? Well, that's a bit more complicated. Green is a much brighter color, so it is a lot easier to light up. And also, it is a lot more forgiving when it comes to shadows and wrinkles. Of course, if the scene that you want to put in place of the green screen is a well-lit scene, like a sunny day, you can easily get away with using green because the light of the scene will completely cover the green edges. But if the scene is supposed to be dark, then you would be better off using a blue screen. The benefit of using a blue screen is that it almost has no color spill, so it can preserve the edges much better. But like everything in life, there is a catch. Blue screens need so much more light on them to eliminate any sort of shadows. Blue screens are also a bit harder to key out if the blue is not uniform. So as you can see, choosing green or blue is completely based on the situation you want to film in. Always try to picture the frame in your head and then decide on the color you want to use. The only thing that you should take care of now and is common between both colors is how to set your set. First, you gotta make sure that the cloth is completely ironed and wrinkle free. Any sort of shadows or inconsistencies in color will bring up complications later on in post. Next, you gotta light the screen and the subject individually. The light, especially the light on the screen, should be soft yet strong. It is also good practice to have a backlight behind the subject casting light on them so that their edges will be lit and free of green light spill. This can really help out later on in post when trying to key out the green screen and you want to keep the edges nice and sharp. Also, try to make sure that your subject is not casting any sort of shadows on the screen. Try to ask them to do different moves in front of the screen so that you can make sure of that. It is always best to keep a distance from the screen to alleviate any sort of these issues. Finally, it should go without saying, do not have anything on set that is green beside the green screen. Anything, no matter how small, can turn into a big distraction after keying the footage, and that is a huge pain to fix in post. Now that's out of the way, let's talk about the post-production phase of the work. Okay, let's begin. After importing both your footage into Premiere Pro, it is time to stack them on top of each other in our sequence. First, the footage that is going to replace the green screen, and then the main footage will go on top of it. Next, I'm gonna look for Ultra Key in my FX panel and then drag and drop it onto my main footage. Now, moving to the FX control panel and going down the list, I can find the Ultra Key here. I'm gonna use the color picker and choose the green screen to key it out. For almost all cases, this will work just fine, but if you see some issues with the end result, you can always move and work with these sliders here. For example, shadow and pistol are the first ones I will always tweak if I see any issue in my footage. Okay, that's about it. I hope today's video was helpful and helped you up your video editing game. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe to our channel, click the bell icon to be notified of the new videos we are going to put up in the next few weeks. Best of luck and bye.